All right, guys. My name is lilshef. Welcome back to episode of the Gonzaga series. We are finished with season two. We just went 13-1, number 17 in the nation. Won our first bowl game ever. Ready to advance to the offseason because why not? Ready to get another season started, baby. Ready to see what these guys could do. Anthony Cannon, level 12. Derek Flanagan locked us out. No surprise there. Xavier Dennison also locked us out. These are both custom recruits. If you guys don't know, every offseason we add custom recruits to the list. Let's see if I can get them. And if we don't get them, we see where they're going. That's the whole purpose of them still being on my board. I need to know where they go so I can keep track and see what's going on there. We won Coach of the Year. I just saw that. Congratulations to us. They want it. All right. You want to extend my offer? Sweet, dude. Target wins 8 per year. I think we could do that. Let's go ahead and accept that because that looks good for my recruits. Just sign an extension. You know what I mean? We're good there. Coach Carousel. All right. I was going to see if anybody wanted to, if anybody left or went anywhere. I guess not. Players leaving. See what's going on there. I guess we'll see at this next stage. I'm kind of curious. If we got new coordinators, maybe we got somebody good. Hopefully. I think they're about like 8 or 9. If we can get like 2 old head coaches that are now my coordinators, all maxed out, we'll be sitting pretty, dude. We'll be perfect. I would love that. So I need to level up my coach again. That way we can put some more points starting on the guys next year and get some of those visits up and finally be able to compete with some of the bigger schools for some of the custom recruits because we definitely need them, man. Anthony Cannon, level 12. I already know that. You told me that a while ago. Maybe. Well, we were already level 12. All right, coach changes. I'm just curious. See if we lost anybody for our team. Lane Kiffin. What? He's now the offensive coordinator of Alabama. No real surprise there. Mountain West. All right, we're looking for us. Sign extension. Left for new job. No. No, Anthony Concepcion. We're going to miss you, buddy. Don Treadwell. All right. I don't know who you were, but maybe you'll be good. See, like Utah State got head coach Bob Stoops. I was like, what? No, we're looking for Don. Anthony Cannon signed an extension. That's what we do. Treadwell fired Wyoming offensive coordinator. Great. They were almost the last. Come on, man. Why'd you have to come to my team? The heck's wrong with you? Players leaving. Anybody? Oh, transfer playing time. Yo, dog, you're going to get a play this year more than likely. You know what? You're going to start in more than 9 games. Sorry, coach. I'm going to play another school. Well, get the heck out, and I'll beat you every year just to rub it in your daggum face, man. Nobody going pro. Sad. Oh, well. You know, those guys are good enough anyways. On to the next one. Transfer request. Oh, got a free safety want to come in. Yeah, we'll admit him. Why not? We got plenty of opportunity to come play for us. So why not? I mean, I'll probably bench you, but why not? We got scholarships available. We're good. Seems something like we should be able to do. Commencing graduation ceremonies. There goes all my seniors. Like I said, we're not hurting. They were projecting us to be number 96 to start the next year. Nah, dog. Nah. Not going to happen. If we do, something wrong. 100% of the way wrong. I'm telling you. We are not no 96 overall team. The top 50, at least. Checking out my recruiting board. See what I need to figure out what to put points on. Nope, we don't know where they're going yet. Let's see, typically I kind of keep it in a certain order. I mean, John Coles will be nice. John Rogers not really going to get a chance to play. But what kind of point system are you? What are you? Yeah, you'll be all right. I'll put some points on you. So I'm going to put my points on the guys I want to put them on. We'll be right back. All right, so just got done putting my points on them. Ryan Mann is the first guy we want. 6'3 overall, 76 middle linebacker. He'll be all right. He'll probably come in and play because we need linebackers. The other guy's the corner. It's because it's never too bad to have a corner. I didn't go for the JUCOs. I instead went for Thomas Miller just because I think he's going to be a little bit better for us down the road. I mean, he could be a running back, maybe. Could be a secondary safety guy, maybe. Just not a whole lot to go from, but we get the opportunity to mess with him a little bit. Then I also went for Matt Hawley. Just because Forrest is our athlete, decent stat-wise, he could sit a couple of years and then he'll get a chance to play. But that's the only guys I put points on, man. Typically, I like to spread it around as much as possible. And I'm happy with my 10,000 point allocation. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to advance into signing day, see who we got, see where the other guys, the other custom recruits end up going to. Just because, like I said, keep my spreadsheet rolling, see who goes where. Even though last year, I think Matt Gonzalez and then CU Freeze, who I have on my team, They're the only two I got. Well, Matt and like one other dude, the only ones that played all year long. Like, that was it. Everybody else was red shirts. Like, y'all could have all came and played for my team. But no, they didn't want to play for me. They would rather sit the bench, which is just fine. It's all good, man. No big deal. No harm, foul. It's a no harm, no foul. No harm, foul. You don't hunt birds. It's wrong. I'm just messing with you. You can hunt whatever you want, except for people. It's against the law. Fogle, we got. I don't know if we even forced him, but it says halfback, Holly quarterback. Miller's supposed to be a halfback, and John Cole's supposed to be a corner. We got Jeremy Jackson, though. Yeah. What up? All right. What are we looking for? We didn't get McCoy, wide receiver. Dennison goes South Carolina. Flanagan goes Cal. We didn't get Ryan Mann. Wow. That was the one guy like, I wanted. Wanted him. Top class in conference. What up? Or did we get that last year? I don't know. I'm saying we got it this year because we are straight ballers. Signing day. See, I wonder what happened with Ryan Mann. I like to always look and see how close I was to getting that. Now, something that bugs me, and I found this out from the Death Penalty series, is the computer auto-signs people. Like, I didn't offer scholarships to everybody, but I auto-signed them. Lost by 800 points. 1,000 more points, we would have been good. George Brown, TCU. Graham, we got. We didn't even put any points on him. Thomas Miller, we got. Happy about that. Jeremy Jackson, putting points on him. Got him. So, Derek Flanagan, bam. He's gone to Cal. He'd update my spreadsheet. And then, who else was it? Saving Dennison. Going South Carolina. South Carolina jumped up in front of Florida State to steal him away, too. Man. So, we'll keep tabs on those guys. See where they, or how they do this next season. Or throughout their career. Because I'm always curious, man. I have it like broken down by overall. And then after every season, I'll go in and update the overall and stuff like that. Because that's the type of person I am. I'm not like a stats guy, but I like information. It's kind of weird. That's the reason why I use Facebook. Like, I don't post anything, man. I just like seeing everybody else's information. It's just, I'm a weird dude. I don't take that the wrong way. Position changes. See what we got moving on. I want to move some people around and see what we got going on over there before. I mean, look at that. The freshman coming out 81. My fourth best player on my team. I mean, before the training results, but still. Siege, dude. So we're going to do this real quick. We'll be right back. All right, it's good to know with position changes. I didn't really do a whole lot quarterback-wise. No really any reason to move anybody. Win probably still gets a start. We'll see how much he improves compared to Matt Smith. But he's been the go-to guy so far, so we might keep him. Same thing with George. I mean, it's going to be iffy because Steele's a lot faster, dude. A freaking lot faster. So we'll see. I got a freshman on my red shirt, so I have three running backs. Two freshmen. We'll be good there. Fullback took a dive. Same thing with receivers. Didn't really get anybody this year. We're going to push next year more than likely, unless we add some this year to the board. But not a big deal. I mean, I got my, I can redshirt all of them. There's like not a single one other than Osborne who's been redshirt yet. So we got some advantages there, but they're going to improve this year. Same thing tight end. We're going to need some tight ends before long. Offensive line, this is where we're hurting a little bit. I'll probably redshirt McNeil first because I got two seniors and he'll get to start, bam, next year as a freshman. Adams will probably start all throughout his career. 78 R overall is like second best on my line. He's better than my right guard for sure, who's a senior. And Selman, I think he's going to get leapfrogged by Newberry. So we'll see as a JUCO or as a JUCO junior coming in. We'll definitely figure that out. Freeze probably get the start over Kane just because he's a custom recruit and I want to see what he can do. So we'll definitely see there. Other side, Samson going to get the go more than likely. Defensive tackle, not really a whole lot. My linebackers are horrible. They're straight trash. That's why I said I needed linebackers. Bennett, true freshman coming in. He'll get the start his whole career. 81 coming in right off the bat. And then Mendoza on the outside is a senior as well. So linebacker core, very thin. Corner, not so much. We got a lot of experience. We got three juniors, one JUCO transfer in, or JUCO recruit, freshman recruit. He's going to get leapfrogged by Robinson, which is fine. But we'll probably redshirt a couple of them just so these other guys can play. I mean, they're not hurting us right now. We can hold on to the speed and ability for a couple of more years since these other guys haven't been really redshirt yet. As far as safety position, Justin Lama's set. He's good. Simmons, we got the transfer coming in. He's got to sit out this year. So Madison will be the backup as of right now. And then Thomas, who he's an athlete, he actually makes a pretty good. So he's 77 overall corner, 76. Strong safety, but he's 79 free safety. He's just not going to play over Tesla Lama. Not going to happen. So put him here. Preston Butler, the other custom recruit we got. I might redshirt him this year and give him the start. His sophomore year. just because, I mean, this is going to be hard to pass up. Thomas is just a little bit better. Nothing we could do. Kicker, punter, we're good. Like I've mentioned before, everybody that I'm getting rid of just moved to punter, so I know I need to get rid of these six guys. And it just helps move the cut players process along a lot better. So we're going to do that, or we're going to go trading results and then cut players, just because we definitely improved. We definitely improved. I had a recruit that was my fourth best overall player. It's not going to show him here because it doesn't show him in training results, but still, that's insane, dude. Yeah, we improved a ton. Tesla Lama plus 5. He's going to be a 90 whenever he's a senior. He's going to be my first 90, dude. Him and Bourbon. Holy crap. That's going to be big, man. So Smith, leapfrogged, win even further. They both went up plus 5, so I'm undecided, dude. He's got a little bit more speed, but Wynn's got the awareness. He's got more break tackle, more elusiveness, more juke. He just can't carry the ball as well. He could jump. His throw power and throw accuracy are way better. So we might actually give Matt Smith a start by the time this comes out. I still wouldn't have decided. So you guys let me know who you think, Matt Smith or Wynn. And we'll go from there. Running game, George will get the start. I'm happy with that. Steele will be a nice contrast between him. I mean, speed's plus 6 difference, and his acceleration's plus 8 difference. So it's going to be a huge difference between these two guys coming in. So I'm happy with George getting the start. Receiver-wise, Green, the number one dude. Kenny, number two. Tanner, three. And I'll probably actually end up putting Gonzalez at number three and then Tanner, four. Unless we have a new recruit coming in there between then. But pretty solid trending results as is. Hunter improves again. Plus 4. Offensive line, we're something else there, man. That's for dang sure. Defensive end, Freeze up a 76, dude. Yeah. Get on that field, boy. Let's see what you can do. 74 or 84 on the other side. Defensive lineman, 70s. We're good. Mid to upper 70s. Linebackers, just not good. Not good at all. Mendoza as a senior's 80. My freshman starting 81. Just going to say. Bourbon up to an 85. Chef up to an 82. That's what I'm liking to see, man. Look, Bourbon got that awareness up. 96. Zeesh. Robinson had a pretty good year. Both Robinsons did, actually. Not related at all. But one of them will probably sit. Test goes up plus 5. Simmons, the transfer we got coming in, plus 4. And then Duncan, plus 4 as well, which he'll be on the bench. He's not going to play. If he does, I'll be surprised. Cut players. Training results went pretty good. Happy with what we've got. Happy with the improvements we have made. Training results to cut players. We need to cut. I mean, I like the definitely series. I don't have to cut anybody. This series, I don't have to cut anybody. We're still 5 players under the roster limit. But I need to cut 6. So we'll be, 11 players under the limit? Which is just fine by me. I hit Y because, as you can tell, my bottom bar sometimes is gone. Coach XP, I can't tell what button to hit. So I just hit buttons until it figures it out what I need to do. Yeah, we're going to be 59 out of 70. So we can get 11 recruits before it even gets us up to the limit. Not counting the seniors that we're going to lose. Which, 3, 4, 5. So at 10 at Flynn, 11. So we need 22 recruits to come in to even hit 70. And I don't think that's going to happen. So we got a long ways to go, man. We're good. We're not hurting on roster positions, man. Y'all want playing time? You got playing time. Custom conferences. We're not going to do anything here other than take a look at our new coaches, because surely we get to reevaluate where their points are at. That coordinator that got fired from Wyoming for being like last in the nation for offense, even though we've been powerhouse team, it's ridiculous, man. He better be good. If he's like a 2 or 3, that's bullcrap. I'm gonna be not happy about it, man, because we've built Concepcion up a long ways. He was our, I mean, we had him last year, we had him this year, and now our third season, he bolted for another position. Now I don't blame him. It's whatever. More power to you. Happens all the time. Okay, let's take a look. We're not going to jump conferences yet. We just won our first conference championship in our first year in the conference, so I'm good here. But we will take a look at the skill trees. That's a level 4. Are you serious? Level 4. All right, so he actually is an improvement over what we had. What we got? I'm gonna reset this. Let me reset it then. Don Treadwell. So I'm not big on no huddle and stuff. So we're gonna go increase the carrying That's going to be a big thing for us. And then probably break tackle and catch. Throw power, throw accuracy, not a big deal. But we like to be a little shifty with the ball, man. So we're going to do that. We like to run it. So we're going to go a little bit different than what he was. He was more pass heavy. Now he's going to be more run heavy because that's what we want to do. And we'll level you up and we'll put some more points on you, little buddy, and we'll be okay. But as of right now, we're done with the offseason, man. Next stage will be preseason. I'm going to load it up. That's going to be a separate video. We're doing that so I can make the custom recruits and all that. If you guys still want to have a shot at being in it, make sure you leave the comment down below of what you want to be. We need offensive line, middle linebackers, and secondary. Like big playmakers, I might take one or two, like a halfback, wide receiver, quarterback, something like that. But my fullback, tight end, like just key positions you need. Y'all literally just saw what I needed looking at my team, man. Seniors and all that. You know what I need. Put down something that I could actually use, and we'll go from there. Patreon guys get first dibs, and then I'll go through and pick a couple of guys and get them created. But next video, we'll be setting up the depth chart, custom schedules, all that, and then custom recruits. Maybe you can see if you made it or not to the list. If I didn't get you, there's always next time. It's going to happen. I'm not going to be able to pick everybody because 15 last year was brutal, especially trying to get them all because I pushed for them first because I want to make sure I have an opportunity to get them. But we'll see. I think 10 will probably be my limit this year, but you never know. But as of right now, that's it for this episode. If you guys are new, be sure to subscribe. If you like the video, be sure to leave a like. My name is Little Chef, and I will see y'all next time.